What's up guys, Syiler here, and I am back with another video, and this time we're going to be looking at 50 plus easy to obtain mounts in World of Warcraft. These are going to be very cheap or guaranteed drop chance, or if they're not guaranteed, the very high drop chance, so you're not going to be doing it for very long, or the quest line is pretty short, easy to do. Basically, mounts that are obtainable very easy, as the title states. And I've also included a few more than 50 just so that regardless of your playstyle, there should be a good few mounts that you're interested in picking up. So first up on our list is the faction mounts, and it's a little bit of a cop-out, but I think it's really worth mentioning because it's 55-ish mounts from Horde or Alliance, and then an additional 12 from the neutral faction Pandaren. That is a lot of mounts to add to your collection if you haven't already, and it's fairly easy to do. If you have any characters that are level 40 or above, log on to them and you'll be able to head over to their faction vendor and buy the mounts from that vendor. As a race, say for example Dwarf, will be exalted with the Dwarf faction and will be able to go and buy the mounts pretty much instantly as soon as they hit level 40, as long as you've got the gold. So it's worth looking through and seeing if there's any faction mounts that you haven't bought yet that you have a character eligible for, and if you don't worry, there's actually a few ways around this. The first up is to make a Death Knight. If you make a Death Knight of the faction that you're missing, say for example Orc, you're missing the Wolves. If you make an Orc, you go through the Death Knight starting area, it takes about an hour-ish, and then head over to Orgrimmar and head over to the mount vendor. You'll be able to buy all the mounts from that vendor. So it doesn't take very long to pick up a good chunk of mounts. The other option is to head over to the Quartermasters for the faction you're interested in finding or growing. For example, if you're interested in Orc or Troll, you'll head to Orgrimmar, and you'll be able to buy a Tabard, and while you equip that Tabard, certain mobs that you kill from like dungeons and things like that will award you reputation, and it's just a very passive way of getting your reputation up anyway if you're looking to do that. And then you can go, once you're exalted, go and buy those mounts. Now the last option is unconfirmed for 2018. It was working in 2016, 2017, but that is to do a class trial. You make a class trial, you go through the class trial, and when you're done, you can head over to the class vendor, or the race vendor, and buy the mounts. Now, I'm not 100% confirmed if that's still working, though. It did work at one point, so that's a little bit of a guessing game whether you want to give that a go. And if you do give it a go, and it works, let me know. I wasn't able to try it because I have all the mounts anyway, so I'm not able to confirm if it does or doesn't work right now. So there you go. That is a good chunk of mounts that you can pick up fairly easily. And to be fair, that could be the video over. That's 67-ish mounts right there from one tip. The next mount on our list is the Bronze Drake, which is a timed dungeon run from a Wrath of the Lich King dungeon. You had to run through the dungeon in a specific amount of time and then kill an extra boss that was hidden away. If you didn't do it in time, the mount would no longer be there. And with us out-leveling this greatly now, this shouldn't be a problem whatsoever as it's a Wrath of the Lich King dungeon. So we're going to head over to the Caverns of Time in Tanaris. You can get there through the old Dalaran portal or through Uldum and just fly over. We're going to go into the Cullen of Straffleholm, and you're going to make sure you are on Heroic Dungeon Difficulty by right-clicking on your character portrait. You're then going to speak to Chromie. If you've never done this dungeon before, she will have a little quest for you to do to spray some crates. Then you'll run up the path, speak to her again, go through some RP, and you'll be on the bit I'm on right now where you need to speak to Arthas and you can finally begin the dungeon. So this first section of the dungeon is basically just running around and killing these flagged mobs. Not just the random zombos, but the actual mobs on the map that are marked with a flag. When you kill so many waves of those flagged mobs, a boss will spawn. And then once the boss is dead, you'll have a few more seconds to kind of wait for the next wave of mobs to spawn. You'll need to do this twice, you'll have two bosses to kill, and then we'll be done with this section. As I mentioned, this is a Wrath of the Lich King heroic dungeon, so if you have a character at least like Mr. Pandaria level, like level 90 and above, you should have no problem with soloing this at all. And most people nowadays should have a 110 character at least, so for a 110, this should be zero issues. And once we're done with all the waves, you might get a little bit stuck finding the mobs, just press on your map and you'll see a little white flag and that will guide you to where you need to be next. Once the second boss is dead, we're going to head over to this little inn. And you'll speak to Arthas stood outside, and then he'll walk inside, and we basically need to escort him through this building. Shouldn't be any difficulty at all, though. Just make sure he doesn't die to anything, you know, make sure there's no mobs left on him, beaten on him, and just kill everything off, and he'll carry on running through the dungeon, more waves will spawn, and that's pretty much it. So this is pretty much the normal dungeon run that you'd be doing, except obviously we're trying to do it as quickly as possible. As I mentioned, though, with the strength of your character now compared to back then, you do it in plenty of time. You'll have minutes and minutes to spare, so don't worry too much about the time on the clock. You can see it though on the top, middle top of the screen. That's how much time you've got left in case you're worried. But basically, once we kill this boss, we're pretty much done with the timed run. You do need to speak to Arthas, get him to carry on with the dungeon run, and then he'll lead you down. And then once we're down to the bottom, you don't need to speak to Arthas again. You can leave him there if you want, or you can guide him through. It's up to you. It really doesn't make any difference. But we're just going to run straight down this corridor, killing any zombies on the way if you have spoke to Arthas so he doesn't die. And once we get to the very end, you're going to have two options, to go right or to go forward. If you go right, that's to the true last boss. But if we go forward and left, it's to the hidden boss, which is going to give us the mount. So make sure you are taking that forward and left path and going to the actual mini boss, not the real end boss. And there you go. You got yourself a 100% guaranteed mount. Congratulations. Continuing on with the 100% drop chance mounts, we have two more, and that is the Black Drake and the Twilight Drake. Both of these are 100% drop chance, but the one that you get will depend on the difficulty you're doing in Obsidian Sanctum. So 10 man will reward the Black Drake and 25 man will give the Twilight Drake. Now, as it is a raid, you can only do it once per week on one character, but you could come in on a different character doing the other difficulty and getting both mounts in the same week if you have two eligible characters, two characters high enough level, basically. As it's only a level 80 raid, so once again, like a 90 plus character should be pretty much fine doing this. So they do both come from Obsidian Sanctum, which is in Wrath of the Lich King, and there you want to head to Dragonblight and then Wormcrest Temple, smack bang in the middle, and you want to come in from the north side and go down this kind of deeper section into the bottom side of Wormcrest Temple, and then put the raid on the difficulty that you want. As I said, 10 man Black, 25 man Twilight, and what you want to do is just immediately kill Cetharion. The way you get this mount is by having all of the three Twilight Drakes around the raid alive and active for when you pull the main boss. And they'll come into the fight and they'll make it a little bit harder. But as you've seen for a 110 character, the boss just instantly dies. And then once you loot him, you will be rewarded with your Drake. It's easy as that. Another 100% drop chance mount is the Amani Battle Bear, and this comes from the dungeon Zullamen. This used to be the Amani War Bear, and it came from the raid Zullamen back in the Burning Crusade, but that was removed, the mount was removed at least, and the raid was turned into a dungeon in Cataclysm, and the mount was brought back as the Amani Battle Bear. Very similar to the Cullen of Strath, all you need to do is complete the first four bosses in a set amount of time, and if you're able to do it within that time, you will get the mount. So to get to Zullamen, we need to head to the Ghostlands, which is in Eastern Kingdoms. You can take a flight path there, and it will get you there pretty quick. And once we're at Zullamen, or if you have Horde, you can take the portal to Silvermoon, and that works just as well. Make sure you are on Heroic Dungeon difficulty, head inside, speak to Vol'jin, and then he's going to run over to this gong that you need to click with him. Just click it once, and you'll start beating on it, and eventually it will open. And once the gates open, the timed run will begin. So essentially all we have to do is kill the first four bosses in the same order that I do. The order doesn't really matter, but this order is just what I'm used to. And you'll get this done. Now this is a Cataclysm dungeon, so it's going to be level 85, so you're going to need about a level 100 character to do this, you know, easily. And make sure you are killing the trash all the way up to this boss. And then once we're done with the trash, we can get to the boss. Actually, I don't even know if the gate's locked without killing trash, but just kill it anyway. It takes like 2 seconds. Once the boss is dead, you don't need to free the prisoner. You can just move on to the next boss. It's only the last prisoner that we actually need to free for the mount. So moving on to the bear boss next, and you will need to kill this guy's trash. Every time you kill the wave of trash he sends at you, he's going to move back a little bit more, and then you'll need to kill the next wave, and keep doing that until he's attackable. Once he's attackable, kill him. And then we're done with two of the four bosses. You know, really, really quick and easy this place. So we're moving over to the Dragonhawk boss next. Don't get as confused as I do on that little section. And there's no trash in particular you need to kill here. Just make your way to the boss, kill any trash that you've accidentally pulled. And then that's three of four bosses down. Finally, we're going to head over to the Lynx boss. And this is the fourth and final one that's going to give us the mount. So as I said, the previous three have prisoners that you can free, but the prisoners freeing them doesn't do anything for us. So once we're here, we're going to kill this boss, and assuming this is the fourth boss we've killed, we're going to free the prisoner from the cage that I just did. She's going to run around and break all these different vases, and then eventually she's going to come over to this one in the back left corner. And when she breaks that, you're going to be able to loot it, and you'll get the Armani Battle there. So there you go, that is another 100% guaranteed mount. If you've killed the bosses in this order, then this will be the one that you get the mount from. So congrats. And let's move on to the next mount. So some more very easy mounts to add to your collection. Three very easy ones and one that's a little bit more difficult. The catch with these ones though is you can only use them inside the raid that they're obtained from. But they do add to your total mount collection. So if you're trying to hit a mount achievement like criteria, you need three more mounts, then definitely do this. So to get these mounts, we need to head to the Temple of Ankaraj, which is in Silithus. And then here, it's a 20-man raid. You're going to head inside, and there's two ways of approaching farming these mounts. The first is to just kill the trash before the first boss over and over again. And within a few runs, you'll have all blue, green, and yellow ones. And if you're lucky, you might have the red one. As I said, the red one is a little bit more rare. Or you can run through, and then once you've cleared the trash, you run out, you reset the raid, and you come back in. Eventually, you will get locked out, but you can go away, do some other stuff, come back, and do it again. Or the other method is to basically just run through the whole raid. There's quite a lot of trash in the raid and hope that you get lucky and get all four. And if you don't, you can maybe come in and out and do it again, or you can come back next week when it resets. Actually, I think this raid resets every 3 days or something weird as well. So you can do it more frequently as well. Up to you. Just decide the way you want to do it. But it is three very easy mounts to add to your collection. And as I said, the chance of having that fourth one as well. So the only downside is you can't use them, and they're kind of cool too. It's a shame, but hey, it is what it is. So if you just have to pure mount numbers, would definitely recommend these mounts from AQ. The next four mounts are a little bit more difficult to obtain because they're a little bit more RNG heavy and locked behind a questline, but I still think they're pretty accessible for most players, especially if you're a level 120 character. If not, you need to be at least 110 to be able to do this, and 110 with a little bit of gear too. So these four mounts come from something called a Fel Spotted Egg, which drops from one of three rare elites found in Argus. Argus is a Legion zone. To unlock Argus, you need to have done a quest called the Hand of Fate, the quest line Hand of Fate. And you can get that from either one of two places. The first is from Khadgar in Dalaran. If you head over to Dalaran, head over to the Violet Citadel, he might have the quest for you already. If he doesn't, then you need to start the quest line for the Broken Shore, which is another zone within Legion. And when you've done the first three or four quests in there, you'll get that quest called Hand of Fate. Do that chain and you'll be sent to Argus. Now, the further you quest into Argus, the more of the zones you'll unlock. By default, you'll have one. A little bit more into the chain, you'll have two, and then much later into the chain, you'll have three. So it's up to you. You could literally just get to Argus, unlock the first zone, and then just kill the one mob you're able to kill once per day. You're able to kill it once per day per character, and do it that way. Or you can quest through the line and unlock all three zones, which will give you access to the three rare elites, which is going to increase your chance of getting more Fel Spotted Eggs. Fel Spotted Eggs have about a 40% chance of dropping from these rare mobs. We're killing one of them currently. And then from the egg, you're going to have a much lower chance of getting the mount. So the more Fel Spotted Eggs you can get, the higher the chance is you're going to get one of the mounts from it. And per day, I don't think this will take you very much time. As I said, you can only kill it once per day anyway. So you just run over, check if it's alive. If not, come back in a couple of hours, see if it's alive, and keep doing that. And then once you've killed it for the day, you don't need to touch it until the next day. You can kill all three of them once per day, though. So you could go around, get potentially three eggs per day. So the three mobs, one is called Sabul, and he's in Makari. The other is Narua, he's in Korkun. And then we have Vagabond we're killing now, which is in Antoran Wastes. And this one's a little bit more difficult to find, as it's actually in the lava. You'll jump into kind of like the lava lake. And then there'll be a little cave, as you can kind of see on the top of my screen. That's the lava lake. You'll walk into this cave and we'll find Varga. So this is the one, and this is Narua. This is in Korkun. This is Sabul. You'll find in Makri, basically the dots on the screen. And then finally, this is the one Varga in Antoran Waste. As you can see, it's a little bit deceptive as it's showing it on land, but it's actually in a cave. So there you go. That is the next mount on our list. The next mounts on our list are the Garrison Stable Mounts. There's going to be six total, plus the two bonus ones as well. And you're going to have to do about 12 days of dailies, but they don't take very long. They're pretty straightforward because it is level 100 content. And once you're done with that, you will be rewarded six mounts. So I think it's quite good for the time invested. Now, to get these mounts, you will need a garrison and you will need the stables building within your garrison. If you don't have a garrison, chances are you've not unlocked Warlords of Draenor, which means you'll need to go and do that. And to do that, head to Blasted Lands, which is in Eastern Kingdoms. There you'll find Khadgar, and you'll be able to basically speak to Khadgar. He'll put you on a quest line. They'll take you into the dark portal. You'll be in Warlords of Draenor, and then you'll fail to follow that quest through. You'll eventually escape from Tanan Jungle. You'll be at Frostfire or Shadowmoon Valley, depending on what faction you are. You'll do a few more quests, you'll build your garrison, and there you go, you finally got your garrison. Now you will need to do a little bit more and upgrade your garrison to level 2, which will take some resources and some gold. And then once you're finally done with that, we can build our stables level 1 and start on the quest line. So the first quest is basically to go and capture a beast, like a wild beast. You'll throw a lasso on it, you'll follow it around, make sure you're mounted for this because it'll make it a lot easier. And eventually it'll tire out and you'll catch it. You'll need to do that for a few of the beasts, and then you'll need to train your beasts first, other like creatures out there. And once you're done with 12 days of that, you'll eventually end up in Nagrand, where there's like harder ones that you need to graduate. And once you've killed all those, then the mount will become trained and you'll be able to actually use it as a mount, which will go in your collection. And it'll add towards your total mount total. It'll be usable wherever you want to use it. Easy as that. Now you can also, once you've unlocked your 6 mounts, you can upgrade your stables to level 2 and level 3. And inside your stables will be an item you can click on, one for level 2 and a different one for level 3. And if you go back to Nagrand with your beasts and fight those like graduation beasts again, then you'll unlock a bonus mount for doing it on level 2. And then when you get your garrison to level 3, sorry, your stables level 3, then you'll be able to do it again and get the 8th mount. So 6 mounts by default, and then a bonus 2 that you can do for doing like the hard mode version. But still, it's pretty easy, and I think most players would be able to do it. But by default, we're just mentioning the 6 mounts, and then there's those 2 bonus ones you can get as well. We're going to be taking a look at some vendor-based mounts next, and the first ones are from the guild vendor, from either Orgrimmar or Stormwind. You will need to be exalted with the guild you're in, and the mounts that are available between 1 and 4 will depend on what your guilds achieve. So an older guild that's been around for a while probably has 4 of the mounts unlocked, while a newer guild probably has maybe 1 unlocked. So you can check your guild vendor, as long as you're exalted with your guild, the reputation, you can see what they've got available. And these mounts range from a few thousand gold, max of like 3,000 gold, so fairly cheap. Now, if you're in a guild that doesn't have many, maybe you could put an alt into an established guild, build up to exalted with them, buy the mounts, and then maybe even leave. It's up to you, but that's one way of getting some pretty easy mounts that look decently cool. Next up, we have quite a few mounts purchasable by gold with no real requirements behind them. We have the Riding Yaks, which you'll be able to get 2 for 3,000 gold each, roughly. Then we have the Blue Riding Wyvern or Griffin, depending on your faction. That's about 2,000-3,000 gold. And then we have the Mammoth for 10,000 and the Tundra's Mammoth for 20,000. And then also the Armored Bear for 750 gold. Now, these mounts do scale based on price, based on your reputation with the relevant faction. In this case, some of these are from Kirin Tor. So the first one, we're going to head up to Dalaran. Doesn't matter whether you go to the Northrend Dalaran or the Legion Dalaran. And you'll find this NPC in kind of the northeast section, stood outside of the pet shop. And she's going to sell you quite a few of these mounts. As you can see, I get a bit of a discount because I have the reputation. But in general, you know, you're going to be spending about a few thousand gold. The Tundra Mammoth is a bit more pricey, but it does contain a vendor and a repair, so you can repair with that as well. So it, you know, it's pretty useful to have. On the other hand, we have the ones that come from Kun'Lai. And those, as I said, you're going to be able to pick up 2 of those for 3,000 gold. This is in Pandaria, just above the Yongol Advance. You'll find this little area with yaks. You'll be able to speak to this vendor, and he's going to sell you 3 different yaks, 2 of which cost 3,000 gold each. And then the other one is a bit more pricey, which is going to run you, I think it's like 120,000 gold. But that's a luxury item more than anything. We have another 100% drop chance mount that could also be bought for gold. This is called Garn Nighthowl, or Gal Nighthowl, I think it is. Or Garn Nighthowl, that's the one. And it's kind of a cool looking wolf. As I mentioned, 100% drop chance. It comes from a mob in Warlords of Draenor called Nok Karash. And when you kill that, you'll be able to loot it and guaranteed get this mount. Now, I mentioned this mount can be bought for gold. It is bind on equipped now, so it means you could find it on the auction house for relatively low amounts of gold. Because of how easy this is to kill on a level 120 character, you get a lot of people just putting them up for a few thousand gold. So if you don't want to take the effort to come and get this, then you can easily buy it too. But if you want to come and get it for free, head to Warlords of Draenor and head to Frostfire Ridge. I would recommend being on at least a 110 character, but preferably 120 to make this easier. And then you'll find Nokkarosh and just basically kill him. If it's not up, then wait for a bit and it'll respawn. I don't think the respawn's too long, maybe like 30 minutes. But once it's dead, you can loot that and you will get a mount that is sellable. Doesn't sell for much, but you can also add that to your mount collection. For people who like to PvP and do that kind of content, there are some mounts for you as well. There's the Black War Wolf, Black War Raptor, Black War Kodo, Black War Pork Shredders, quite a few Black War mounts. These are Horde specific, but there are Alliance alternatives as well. And all you need for that is 15 marks of honor per mount. So just do PvP related content, you probably got a bunch of marks of honor if you already do. And then you can head to the vendor in either Orgrimmar or Stormwind, talk to them, and then the marks of honor, and you'll pick up yourself some extra mounts. Now there is also an extra mount that you can get from Winter's Grasp in Wrath of the Lich King. If you're in control of it, a vendor there will sell you the Black War Mammoth for 15 marks of honor also. So an extra one to pick up if you didn't know about that one and you've got the rest. The next mount on our list is the Red Flying Cloud. And this mount comes from the Lore Walker's Exalted, which is a Mr. Pandaria reputation. The nice thing about this reputation, though, is it can be done in one day, even less than that, like 3 or 4 hours of your time. And probably less if you have decent flying and have a better route. But basically, you fly around and click certain items in Mr. Pandaria. When you click so many of them, you'll get sent an item in your mail, which gives you a quest that you can hand in for reputation. Now, one thing to note that's changed since I made a video on this mount way back is when you get to Reverge, you can buy an item from the vendor, which will allow you to gain even more reputation. So I would recommend doing that. And if you check in the description below, there will be a link to my old video that covers how to click, you know, where the things are to click to get the reputation, because covering it in this video would take a little bit too long. So the next three mounts up are going to take a bit more work, and it's a little bit more tedious, but they're still worth it and fairly easy. The first is the Swift Forest Strider and then the Darkmoon Dancing Bear. Both of these cost 180 Darkmoon tickets each. And then the other one is the Darkwater Skate, which is going to cost 500 Darkmoon Dagamores, which is a fish you can fish up from the Darkmoon Fair. The Darkmoon Fair comes around once a month for about a week. So every month you'll be able to do the Darkmoon Fair for a month. And the one I'd say to work on first of all is the Darkwater Skate. Just go fish out there. And eventually you'll get your 500 Darkmoon Dagamores, which could also be bought off the auction house if you don't want to fish, but it is guaranteed after you get the 500 at least. Then I'd recommend fishing up an additional 100 Darkmoon Dagamores and going to the same vendor that you can buy the Darkwater Skate from, and then buying the Faded Treasure Map. Now this is a little bit of a difficult quest line. Well, it's not difficult, it's just like a riddle, basically. So I would recommend following a guide, which I'll link below, to get that done. And once you're done with that, you will get 100 Darkmoon tickets. And then you only need to get 80 more through doing the daily quests that are available there. Or there's some items that you'll see on the screen in a moment that you can buy and that you can hand in at the Darkmoon Fair for tickets also. So within one fair, you should be able to buy one of the mounts. And then if you log onto an alternative character, you could do the Faded Treasure Map again by getting 100 more Dagamores and repeating the same steps you did on your main character to buy the other mounts. So within one Darkmoon Fair, you could get all three of the easier mounts. The final two mounts on our list is the Fathom Dweller and the Riddler's Mindworm. Both of these mounts are basically secret mounts that were added in Legion, and you need to have at least a level 110 character, but you'll just have to follow certain steps, fly around different areas in World of Warcraft, and eventually you'll be rewarded with these two mounts. Now, the Fathom Dweller, you need to kill a mob at the end, which rewards different things each week, and one of the weeks will be the Fathom Dweller, so you might have to keep looking out for that. But the Riddler's Mindworm will be a guaranteed thing at the end of the quest line. And in the description down below, I will add the guides to do these mounts. It's a little bit too long for me to add to this video that is already quite long. So, but it's very accessible content for a level 110 character, very easy to do. As long as you follow the steps right, you'll have no problems at all getting these mounts, and it'll take you an hour or so to do. And that wraps up our video, so hopefully this helped you quite a lot and there was a lot of mounts that you've not gotten that were interested and seemed relatively easy for you to do. I did try to provide a good variety of different content and approaches so that most players watching this will have something they're interested in going and getting from this video. And in the description below will be a lot of different information for each of these mounts, just in case there wasn't quite enough information for each of them in the video. then there'll be more information backing that up in the description down below, so you should have no problems with getting these mounts. This is a video I've been working on. I started working on it months and months ago before BFA even came out, so you'll see some strange things like my character being level 110 and still having artifact power, and that's because I didn't actually finish it up. I recorded a lot of the stuff and just didn't get around to finishing it. So thank you for making it this far into the video, and look out for more videos coming soon. If it did help you, give it a thumbs up, throw me a subscribe, and look out for more videos coming soon. See ya.